Another day, another leak, another potential scandal, but this time the president is not facing the kind of blowback he did after the Benghazi and IRS stories broke. And maybe it's because when it comes to data mining in the name of national security, the majority of Republicans might be on his side.
The National Security Agency is not listening to Americans' phone calls, and it is not reading Americans' emails.
But I do believe that if this was September 12, 2001, we might not be having the argument that we are having today.
One of the central tenets of the Obama presidency is that government can play an important positive role in the lives of the American people. How damaging have these last few weeks been to that argument? Let's bring in our panel. CNN political contributor and Democratic strategist Hillary Rosen, former chairman and CEO of Hewlett-Packard and former Republican Senate candidate Carly Fiorina, and CNN's chief congressional correspondent Dana Bash. Now, clearly, the news of Edward Snowden's leak of government PRISM data collection program may have shocked the media, but do you think, Carly, that voters will be as upset as we in the media seem to be?
Well, I think there are two sides to this. The first is, do you agree with the program? But the second is more fundamental. And I think these fundamental questions voters will start to ask. How is it that we hold vast, complex bureaucracies accountable? How do we know that the people inside these bureaucracies are competent or ethical or have good intentions or are honest? How is it that a few people in Congress, a very few people, or a few people in the White House, regardless of their party, are capable of sufficient oversight? And finally, when you have this much concentrated power in these vast bureaucracies, these complex programs, isn't corruption and abuse inevitable, really?
Dana, President Obama, as you saw earlier in the show, said on Friday that every member of Congress has been briefed. And as you also heard, Congressman Keith Ellison was one of many who has said that he has not been briefed on this program. Tell us what's going on here.
Well, you know, we have lists now from the White House giving us times and dates where they say that members of Congress were briefed on the two programs we're talking about, one dealing, of course, with phones and the other dealing with the Internet. However, here's the real deal. The real deal is people probably won't be surprised to know that their members of Congress do end up voting for things that they don't know about. They don't really know what they're voting for, particularly when it comes to classified information. Members of the Intelligence Committees, they do have oversight, as you were saying, Carly. They get the information, they're briefed, they have votes on the legislation, but it's all done in secret because it's classified. If you are Senator Tapper and you are not on the Intelligence Committee, you can go, and in the Senate in particular, they were invited to come and read a white paper with information about this. But you don't have a staff member who has that security clearance. So you can only learn so much unless you rely on somebody who's in the committee who you don't know. And part of the problem is that members, some of them don't go and get the briefings. And even if they do, they don't really know what to ask because they don't have that kind of experience on these issues.
In many respects, I think that's as much the problem as anything, which is that technology, people are so ignorant about technology generally, and particularly in Washington and too often in Congress. I find one of the most interesting things about this conversation is that we're upset about the NSA getting access to vast amounts of data that commercial companies actually collect on us, that we actually willingly give to commercial companies, and they use it to market it. So when you're talking about, you know,
Verizon already has the information about
Google
the phones.
Google collects already has it every time you go sign on to Gmail or something. So that when you talk about sort of vast bureaucracies who have a huge amount of power, might be out of control, in my mind, you could as easily be talking about these private sector companies. So I think that, you know, the idea that we would be okay with that for marketing purposes, but maybe not okay for terrorist actions, I think that's what's driving people's confusion.
Carly,
around
you
this
were,
I actually think you're raising a really good point. And I think there are two fundamental differences between business and government. Although I agree, business bureaucracies can get out of control as well. First, a business faces competition, mm-hmm. and consumers have choices. They can take their business away. And as a result, every technology company has been extremely actually transparent about what they collect. The difference is there is no competition to government, and taxpayers and citizens have no choices. Again, I personally support this program, but I think we're foolish if we don't say that it raises some questions about how do you hold these kinds of bureaucracies accountable, and how do you hold the people within them accountable
when
you don't
know?
Exactly. The IRS is exactly the same question.
I have to take a quick break right now. Carly, Hillary, and Dana, thank you so much.